Well, hi, everybody, and welcome to another edition of Bengal Magazine. And on today's show, we're going to talk a little hockey. First up, Candice Moxley, the head coach of the women's team at Buffalo State. And Candice is bringing along Viivi Vaattovaara from Finland. I love that last name. And then Eugene Lewis, track and field. Eugene is bringing along Robert Liebel, his outstanding sprinter from Tonawanda, the city of. Steve Murphy joins us. He's the head coach of the men's team, and Steve is bringing along Brody Power, the outstanding defenseman from Nova Scotia. And then we'll also have the Tim Horton Athlete of the Week, and Matt Schaefer's here with Bengal Update. So stick with us. We'll be right back talking women's hockey. All right, let's talk a little women's hockey here at Bengal Magazine. Candice Moxley, the head coach of the Bengals, is with us, along with Viivi. And Viivi, pronounce your last name for everybody.
Vaattovaara.
Ah, that was so beautiful, wasn't it? It had just, I could never do that, Moxley.
I can't do it.
Say it again one more time.
Vaattovaara.
Oh, from Finland, the outstanding senior defenseman for the Bengals. And Mox, outstanding season. Congratulations to both of you. 17 wins, second most in school history from last year's 18 wins. Moving into the playoffs, et cetera, et cetera. When, time to look back, time to reflect a little bit. It's been a week now. I know you're recruiting and all that, but when you kind of reflect on this year and this team, what do you think most of?
We had a great season. There were times where we were fighting consistency, I think, as a team. But all in all, it was a fantastic season for our girls, and we beat a lot of opponents that we didn't necessarily beat the year before.
Right.
And there's also some games that I'm sure we would like to have back and have another opportunity at. But all in all, I think I'm really proud of the group of girls.
Yeah, absolutely. And Viivi, same question to you as a student athlete, someone who's on the ice. When you reflect back on this team, what are you going to think about most?
I mean, how far this team has come the past few years. We've talked about this. Seniors, like banquet, everything, like it's completely different from what it was even 3 years ago. I can't even imagine before that when Mox took over the program.
Right.
It was just, you know, like it wasn't doing well in the conference,
right, sure,
to put
absolutely.
It nicely.
We needed a jump start.
And right now we finished third in our conference.
Right.
And we're head to head with the number one team in the nation
absolutely.
When we play our game. So,
you know, you bring up a good point, head to head with the top team. And, you know, I look at the game with Plattsburgh, the 3-3 tie, mm-hmm. ranked number one at that time. And I ask, what's the next jump? How do you get to that next point in this program now, Mox?
Well, I think a lot of it is now the girls in our locker room have the confidence and have the experience tying a team like that, that's first in the nation, going into a game where you're considered an underdog and performing very well. So I think the confidence for our group of girls that are in our locker room currently, and then it's the recruiting piece as well, bringing in players that can complement what we have in the locker room, and if not, take another step forward with those players.
Any surprises this year? I mean, I do want to mention the Bengals were ranked as high as eighth in the country, first time ever.
Right.
Congratulations on that. Any surprises on the ice with particular players or systems, or did it kind of go the way you thought it would go?
For me, it kind of went the way I thought it would go. I think with Natasha Steinle turning it on second half of the season, I saw that in her when I was recruiting her. I was hoping that she'd be able to find that confidence piece a little bit earlier in her ability to finish and score goals.
Right.
She found it second half, which was fantastic.
And she was named to the all-rookie team.
Yeah.
Very good.
She was able to find that first half. Right. I there's no doubt in my mind she would have been rookie of the year. But hey, everybody has their learning curves, and she definitely took those steps forward.
You know, I look at this young lady. She's been with us for 3 years, and the road is traveled with you, Viivi, that's for sure, from Finland, obviously. But in a story that was written, you had talked about this being the right fit. It's been 3 years now. As you, again, reflect on your career at Buffalo State, how has it been, and what will you remember?
Definitely. I mean, hockey-wise, it's been the best experience I've had. Like, Mox is the best coach I've ever been.
It's amazing I've what ever she'll had. Say for exactly. $20. Huh?
Yeah. No, but not just hockey. School-wise, I've had a lot of opportunities with research and just finding what I truly love doing and what I love studying and actually enjoying school and not have it be something that I hate.
Yeah, kind of a drag sometimes, exactly, as they used to say in my day in the 60s and 70s. But you bring up school and the academic end of things. We should let our viewers know you have a 3.96 GPA and not in underwater basket weaving. You're a major in biotechnology, minoring in psychology. What does the future hold for you? I know there's possibly being a doctor or going into sports medicine. Have you decided where you're going to go?
Yeah, medical school is definitely my
fabulous
top goal. But for next year, I've applied to a master's program in Finland in translational medicine.
Wow.
It's a two-year program, so I figured I would kind of get maybe some more experience and build up my resume in case I do apply to med school in the U.S.
So in 30 seconds or less, what does that mean, translational medicine?
It's the research aspect of being a doctor.
Okay.
Yeah, so I'm doing research here at school, too. I've just gotten interested in doing research alongside with clinical work.
Fabulous. Mm-hmm. She's no longer here. Keep the tears in.
Don't. Yeah.
But in all seriousness, I mean, you've had what you had considered a rock in the locker room. Mm-hmm. What will you miss most about not seeing her next year?
I mean, you're looking at the whole package as a player and a person. So it's going to be really tough leadership-wise and just work ethic. The way Viivi goes about her day-to-day business, she does everything the right way, which is great for all the girls in our locker room to look up to and to respect. And it's going to be, it's going to be tough to lose
that. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Well, on behalf of everybody in the department, thank you for three great years and for being you. And congratulations to both of you on a great season.
Thank you.
We will take a quick break. But before we leave, I do want to remind you about the annual Bengal Club Golf Classic. It's Monday, July 10th at the Briarwood Country Club. If you need more information, please give me a call at the number on your screen or send me an email. That's also on your screen. Again, the Bengal Club Golf Classic, benefiting the student athletes here at Buffalo State, Monday, July 10th at the Briarwood Country Club. Stick with us. We'll be right back.
No matter who you are
or where you're from,
you are welcome here.
Tú eres bienvenido.
Merhaba. Ahlan wa sahlan.
You are welcome
you
here.
You are welcome.
You are welcome here.
Well, congratulations are going out to Rob Liebel from the track and field team. The junior from Tonawanda sprinted to a pair of conference titles on February 24th and 25th at the conference meet, and in so doing was named the outstanding male track athlete of the meet. Liebel captured the 60-meter dash with a time of 7.01 seconds and also crossed first in the 200-meter dash in 22.25. And that time, by the way, is 18th best in the entire country in Division III this season. So congratulations to Rob Liebel, this week's Tim Hortons Athlete of the Week. And funny how we do that, Rob's on the show with us. Welcome, Rob, along with Eugene Lewis, the head coach of the track and field programs here. I was about to say men's, but it's men's and women's.
Absolutely.
At Buffalo State. And welcome, gentlemen. Coach, just got done with the indoors, the conference meet. Why don't you give us a little analysis of how that went? We'll start with the men's side first.
Well, it was a very fun meet, very interesting meet for us. Looking at our current team, we only have one senior, so we have a ton of youth, a lot of freshmen running in their first SUNYVAC championships. And so in terms of individual performances, I felt like we did extremely well. We have a little bit more work to do on the home front when it comes to the overall team outcome. We're kind of missing a few events due to our youth. But overall, we're excited about that men's team. Our women's program is in a rebuilding phase in terms of we graduated some very good seniors last year with Sasha Van and some others. And what we're finding with this group here is that they're kind of developing and learning their talent. a lot of goal setting and a lot of building esteem and that type of thing. So when we look at both programs, we're in a rebuilding phase,
right?
With very exciting prospects.
So Rob sitting next to you, and I'm assuming that's not a surprise what he did in the conference meet by winning the 60 and the 200.
Not at all. Sometimes we try to explain to our athletes what they should expect and understanding what they can do as an athlete in terms of performances. And Rob was well aware of that. And so some of these individuals that he was going into these races with, he had a very good idea of where he placed.
Well, let's talk about that a little bit, Rob. I'm always curious about the strategy of a sprinter. First of all, how did both races go, generally speaking? Did they go as you thought they would?
Yeah, they went actually exactly how I thought. Coach Lewis and Coach Allen prepared me every day in practice. They told me exactly what I needed to do, and I just listened to them and just went out and executed everything we were practicing. The 60 is so short, it goes by so fast, so the start's the most important part. And my start since I've been here has come a long way. Okay. I mean, from my freshman year to now, it's improved drastically.
And let me just stop you there.
That's all right.
So it improves drastically. How does it improve in terms of getting off at the gun or the, I mean, what facets of that are we talking about?
Well, for me, it was my body positioning, my reaction to the gun. Coach Lewis and Coach Allen work a lot with that as my reaction time, because my reaction time is usually pretty slow, and you can lose a lot of time if you don't react to the gun quick enough.
Okay.
So that's where I've improved most is that, my body positioning, my power pushing off the blocks.
And I'm going to assume in the 60, I mean, I'm no rocket scientist, but I'm going to assume that in the 60, the start is the most important part?
Absolutely.
And is that your strategy in every 60-meter dash?
Just about, yeah. If I get a good start, then I know I'm going to run a good race.
And you create the confidence in you right away that you know you're not behind. So I think mentally that's probably a key point too.
Absolutely. I mean, it requires a lot of concentration and discipline.
Cool.
And that's something that as you mature as an athlete, as he has, you get better at it.
Right. So now we go to the 200. So what's the strategy involved in running a 200 dash?
Well, I mean, for me, I drive out hard for the first about 40 meters, relax a little, and then when there's about 100 meters to go, I recommit and reaccelerate to the race.
Wow. So when you say relax, I mean, we need to put that in quotes. Put that in layman's terms.
To be quite frank, the term he used was layman's terms. You know, for coaches, it's a little bit more sophisticated than that in terms of, you're running at your most efficient capacity in terms of your correct running mechanics, correct effort or energy output. And those kids begin to find that zone as they practice that race. And so as you get to that point in the race, you have to be confident in staying true to mechanics, technique, and then your ability comes out in the last 100 meters.
Right. Interesting. When did you know that you were pretty good at this? I mean, you ran at Tonawanda. Was there a time where you kind of said, wow, I am good at this, and I want to continue on and maybe go to college and run?
I qualified for the state championship a couple times in high school, my freshman, junior, and senior year. And then once I did that, I realized I had some talent. And then, I just really have always enjoyed track and field, so I knew I wanted to do it in college.
Wow. Fantastic. A couple minutes left. Now we go to the outdoor season. The indoor season's over. Although we do have an opportunity to move on to the NCAAs, why don't you give us a little idea of what happens now?
Well, right now we're at the point where you have one meet left. Usually it's more of a regional meet. For us, it'd be our ECAC championships.
Okay.
And the way that it works for Division III, they take between the top 18 and the top 20 athletes in each event in the country.
Okay.
So our goal is to finish the final week of the track season or indoor season with a top 20 or higher ranking. And so we have about approximately six individuals that are currently ranked and are in very good position. And we hope to kind of hold our position or improve it over the next weekend.
And the NCAAs are March 10th and 11th, the indoors. Now we go outdoors. We have about a minute and a half, but give us a quick synopsis of the strengths of both programs going
to
the
right
outdoor.
Now, we've always been known as a sprint jump school. We have some very good hurdlers. The big track helps us a lot in terms of some of our taller and larger athletes can take advantage of that. So I feel as though we're at the same place in terms of overall team performance, but I can see our individuals continue to prove what they do you know, transitioning in their freshman and sophomore years.
You have basically a month off now, not off, but between meets. Your next outdoor meet is April 1, I believe. Mm-hmm. So is it starting all over again? Is it like training camp, or are you just moving from indoor to outdoor and evolving from that?
What happens is our national caliber athletes, someone like Rob, will kind of, it's a rest period.
You know,
they'll take some time off, recommit to the books, that type of thing. Some of our other athletes who are developing, it becomes training camp again.
There you go.
There's another opportunity to learn the basics and to continue to improve.
Very good. Well, Rob, congratulations on a great meet. Best of luck in the outdoor season to both of you.
Thank you.
We will take a quick break, and when we come back, we're going back on the ice rink and Steve Murphy, head coach of the men's hockey team. Stay with us.
This winter, you deserve a great breakfast at a great price. Introducing Tim Hortons $1.49 breakfast sandwiches. Choose from the sausage biscuit, sausage and cheese English muffin, or new spicy sausage biscuit for just $1.49 at Tim Hortons.
Hello everyone and welcome to Bengal Update. I'm Matthew Schaefer with a recap of news, scores, and a look at upcoming events surrounding Buffalo State Athletics. After becoming Buffalo State's first swimming All-American in 40 years last season, Connor Mergler officially qualified to return to the NCAA Division III Swimming and Diving Championships for the second straight season after defending his titles in the 50, 100, and 200 freestyle events at the SUNYAC Championships. The junior will look to become the program's first NCAA national champion when he competes March 15th through the 18th. Buffalo State's Mike DeLaverne was named the SUNYAC Goalie of the Year and was a first-team all-conference honoree when the SUNYAC announced its award winners last week. Defenseman Brody Power was also honored, getting named a member of the all-conference second team. DeLaverne finished second in the conference with a .927 save percentage and was third with a 2.06 goals against average. It was a second straight season the senior netminder earned the award. Power, a junior, played in all 27 games for the Bengals and led the Bengal defenseman with 16 points on a goal and 15 assists. Men's hockey set a school record for wins in a season this year with 18 and advanced the SUNYAC semifinals for the sixth consecutive season. On the women's side of things, Erin Guillen was named to the ECAC West second team while Natasha Steinle was honored with an all-rookie team selection. Guillen led the Bengals with 29 points on 18 goals and 11 assists. She now ranks second in school history in both goals and points and is just 3 goals and 2 points shy of both of the school records. Steinle overcame a slow start to the season to finish second in the conference in rookie goal scoring with 14. She added 5 assists to finish with 19 points in 26 games played, including a stretch that saw her tally 14 goals and 18 points in her final 18 games. Buffalo State knocked off Potsdam in the conference quarterfinals for its first playoff win in program history. The Bengals finished the season 17-8-2 overall, just one win shy of the school's single-season record that was also set just a year ago. To the hardwood, Lavelle Smith was named an all-conference first-team selection, while Mike Henry was a second-team honoree when the SUNYAC released its all-conference teams this week. Smith ends his Buffalo State career as the program's 8th highest scoring player of all time with 1,303 points. He finished the year 5th in the conference with an average of 19.9 points per game and was 2nd overall in field goal percentage. Henry led the conference, shooting 56.8% from the field, was 5th in rebounds, and 11th in scoring, averaging 15.3 points per contest. Buffalo State went 17-9 this year and made it to the conference semifinals as the number 5 seed before falling by 1 point in overtime to the eventual SUNYAC champion Oswego. It was the 3rd consecutive season that the Bengals advanced to the playoffs, and with its defeat of Cortland in the conference quarterfinals, the first conference playoff win since capturing the SUNYAC title back in 2011. Both men's and women's track and field teams competed in the SUNYAC Championships this past weekend at Brockport. Robert Liebel raced to a pair of individual titles and was named the Outstanding Track Athlete of the Meet after helping to pace the Buffalo State men to a tie for 4th place. Daytona Holmes and Kataro Burrows each earned second-team all-conference honors to lead Buffalo State's women's squad to a 5th place finish. And spring is almost here as women's softball and lacrosse open their seasons this weekend. Lacrosse hosts Union College in its season opener this Saturday at 1 p.m. out at Coyer Field. Softball is headed to Virginia Beach for the 2017 Beach Blast hosted by Virginia Wesleyan College. The team will partake in two pairs of doubleheaders on Friday and Saturday. That wraps up a busy Bengal update. I'm Matthew Schaefer. Now let's send it back to Tom Koller in the studio.
Well, Matt, thank you for Bengal update. We're joined now by Steve Murphy, the head coach of the men's hockey team here at Buffalo State. And Steve brought along Brody Power, his outstanding defenseman from Halifax, Nova Scotia. I have no idea how he gets to Buffalo, but we'll ask him that. Well, Murph, season's ending, semifinal loss in the playoffs, but fabulous year. As high as eighth, I believe, or ninth in the national rankings, highest ever. You're going to reflect on this. You probably have on your long trips to Michigan to recruit, which aren't so long, we just found out. Yeah. But anyways, what do you think about when you think about this team?
I think you go back and forth. There's times where you think about, a lot of the positives, and we were ranked number nine, and we got off to a great start, and we did reset that wins record, and that's something that is really cool, and the guys should be extremely proud. And then there's times where you think about maybe what could have, or what if, or what could have happened.
Right.
And you go back, and ultimately we're trying to build this team to win a championship, and it didn't happen this year. So I think in the coming weeks we'll take a long look at just what we're doing on the ice, off the ice, who we have in place, what we may be missing, and try to get this thing going in the right direction, and maybe some change coming. But like I said, you go back and forth every day, and hopefully next year is the year.
Same question to you, Brody. I mean, you're on the ice. You're on the ice a lot, as we found out. As you reflect on this team and you being a leader on this team, what are you going to remember?
You know, I think I'm going to look back and see, you know, a lot of positives from this year. The first half of the season, after Christmas, winning the Boston Invitational Landing Tournament. I think moving forward, as Coach said, building towards a championship team, I think we took a lot of right steps this year. And looking back, I'm going to remember all the positives, the rankings, the big wins, the tournament wins.
Yep.
And I think that's really a step in the right direction
Absolutely.
For this program.
Well, you mentioned the big wins. You did have three victories over top five teams at the time you played them. And as I asked Candice earlier, were there any surprises along the way, or did it kind of flow the way you thought it was going to flow this year?
No, I don't think many surprises. I thought maybe we got off to a better start than just because we were so young with so many freshmen, and maybe we got off to a better start and just gelled so quickly. But the expectation is to be a nationally ranked team, and the expectation is to beat those other nationally ranked teams, and we did that, and it's a credit to the guys just of how hard they've worked, and maybe the confidence that they have in themselves and in their teammates, and maybe where this program's kind of come from. So moving forward, that's our expectation, and the guys know that they can play with anybody in the country. But you have to be on your A game, and they know that, and so. Like I said, building and moving this thing forward.
Yeah, and you have to be on your A game for 60 minutes, not just two periods, right?
Yeah.
And 60 minutes, and all teams know that. You've got a rock next to you. He's going to be back next year. What does he mean to this program?
Well, it means a lot. He's ever since I got here and he was a freshman, we've used the heck out of him. And
you sure
he's
have.
Got a lot of miles on those legs. And, he's undoubtedly our number one defenseman. And not just because he showed up and was put in that position. I think he's earned it from day one. And he's got to go out every day just like anybody else and prove that he deserves those minutes and not just, five on five.
There you
special
go.
Teams as well.
Right.
And he does that. So obviously we've been extremely thrilled with what he's become, and we're excited about what he can bring in his senior year.
You know, it's funny. You're an economics major, but he's not using you economically. That's for sure. he's got the accelerator down. You're playing half the game. You're playing 30 plus minutes. How does that feel during the season? I mean, are you conditioned? Are there times where you kind of go, whew, got to have an extra breather here. How do you react to this type of action?
No, I think the season's too short to to look at it and say, you know, I need a break. You try not to think about it.
Yep.
You know, you just go out and you play every game. And I was fortunate enough to have a goalie, Mike Delaverne, who bailed me out more than a fair share of times. And, you know, he made me feel more confident when I played, and it made it a lot easier to play the long minutes.
Very good. Outstanding goaltender. About a minute and a half left, Murph. Time to reload, as they say. You're losing, I believe, six seniors, including Mike, outstanding goaltender. The recruiting trips have begun.
Yeah.
What's the game plan? What are you looking for? How do you reload this program?
Well, we've got a great core,
yep.
And a great core coming back. And so now it's really just, like I said, we'll talk with my assistant Nick here in the next, you know, coming days and coming weeks, and try to find out, you know, maybe what we're missing just to get us over the hump and try to fill in those gray areas and try to get guys that can bring maybe something a little different than our core doesn't have, because those guys that are coming back are going to be looked upon to really lead this thing right out of the gates,
right.
Just like they were, you know, this year and any other year. So, we need a couple forwards and a couple defensemen. We've got a commitment from a goalie, so that's kind of checked off.
Fantastic.
It's not you, no.
Well, safe travels on the recruiting trips, and guys, congratulations on an outstanding season again.
Thanks, Tom.
That's going to wrap it up for us at Bengal Magazine. Thanks to you for viewing, and we'll see you again in 2 weeks for more Bengal Magazine.